Dozens of people were killed today during three jihadist attacks in Kuwait, Tunisia, and Lyon, France.
The situation in Iraq remains very volatile.
Yemen was plunged into darkness today when Al-Qaeda operatives attacked the country's power grid.
A massive effort by the National Security Agency to track cell phone calls and monitor email and internet traffic of virtually everyone.
We've seen each successive president increasingly ruled by executive order. Will Congress fight this dictatorship of secret government? Of course they will.
Your class has an incredible window of opportunity. Lead in shaping a new world order.
There also exists an extraordinary opportunity to form, for the first time in history, a truly global society.
These global corporations, these global banks, will be able to create booms for profit, depressions for profit, even wars for profit.
We must guard again. Acquisition of unwarranted influence, whether sought or unsought, by the military-industrial complex.
Large populations are difficult to control. That's why the future, the globalists have planned, will contain us, will constrain us, will eliminate us.
Ordinary men and women are too small-minded to govern their own affairs. Order and progress can only come when individuals surrender their rights to an all-powerful sovereign.
We have a fog that has descended on our entire nation, the smokescreen of national security, used by government at every level to keep everything they do secret.
We have before us the opportunity to forge, for ourselves and for future generations, a new world order. When we are successful, and we will be, we have a real chance at this new world order.
Their strength is in secrecy, but our strength is to shed light on what they do in the dark and to stand united against it.
You have 10 minutes.
Thank you, Senator. I appreciate the time. My name is Charles Gray. I'm a semi-retired businessman with interests both domestically and internationally. The reason I'm here today is to encourage the U.S. Congress to take action to protect our country from its most imminent threat.
We don't need you to try to educate us on threats.
Your Congress commissioned a study that found that our nation is sustained by a vulnerable and woefully outdated power grid. Your commission found that our enemies, and yes, even we, have developed weapons that are designed to bring down this grid. Your peers determined that immediately after the detonation of one of these weapons, we would lose all sources of power. Electricity would cease to exist. The internet would go down, and along with that, the banking system.
All clear. Search room.
Just who made you the expert on this?
You don't have to be an expert to understand this. You just have to read your own damn findings. According to your report, 90% of the American population will die in the first 12 months.
We're done. There are pressing matters that need to be addressed.
I want you to pass the SHIELD Act, which will harden the grid in our country. I came here to call you to action.
What you got?
Some small caliber weapons, a rabbit gun.
Let's pack them up.
We don't have time for this.
You had time to pass the National Defense Authorization Act, to give the president the power to declare martial law for any reason, to give him the power to arrest any American by simply accusing them of terrorism, imprisoning them indefinitely without charges and no legal counsel.
This was just a funding bill. You have your facts sorely misplaced.
What's wrong with you?
This. This doesn't look like some Al-Qaeda hideout. Looks more like my apartment than some mud hut in Fallujah.
Think too much, eh?
You got a shitty apartment, though.
This hearing is over. Who do you think you are coming in to this committee and making a mockery of our elected leaders, Mr. Gray?
I'm an American citizen who is fed up with an out-of-control dictatorial government.
Don't think, Mr. Gray, that we don't know what you're up to. Stockpiling food, weapons, fuel. The National Defense Authorization Act is there to stop domestic terrorist threats to this country and people like you.
I am an American. I am a patriot. You, sir, are nothing but a traitor.
I've never seen anything like that in my life. That man's a threat to this country.
That little rant will be all over the news tonight.
This plays into our hands. The American news media has our narrative. And in that narrative, Charlie Gray is perfectly playing the role of right-wing extremist. The stigma of that label will stop up the ears of the American public faster than any propaganda we can fashion.
Lieutenant Lane. Sir. Have your men clear and safety their weapons. There'll be a debriefing at 2045. Do you copy?
Yes, sir.
Very well.
But what if even a small percentage of the population were to awaken?
By that time, it'll be too late. Let's just get word out through the proper channels to the American brass who understand the mission. It seems our testing of certain units has gone well. We'll bring up a few of the Russians and the Chinese and integrate them. That will be the perfect litmus test.
Mom's a good boy. Mom's a good boy? Yes, you are. Yes, you are. You certainly are. Okay. Oh, we got a phone call. Can I answer the phone? Can Mom answer the phone? Oh, hey, Charlie. How's it going? No, I'm just working with the horses. Sure. Oh, no, I've already taken care of the cake. Yeah, I thought we discussed that. Uh-huh. Well, what time? Oh, that's perfect. Sure. Well, you know Mama. I don't think we're going to be able to pull the wool over her eyes, but we can certainly try. All right, then. All right, we'll see you later. Bye.
When do you suppose we're gonna go back to base? Try to use them porta potties.
Don't know. When we're told. You think that the government would put a little extra effort into an architect or something? It's weird.
What more do we need? Couple tents, some tins, storage, vacant town down the way. Better than being a base.
Yeah, I guess so. I just really want to know what's in that building. A comm system sucks, and then look at all that hardware. It's just sprouting through the roof. It doesn't make sense.
It's above my pay grade.
Yeah, well, I may have to take a peek.
All right, Sherlock. Need a new hobby.
This ain't a hobby. I got it all figured out.
Is that right?
Mm-hmm. You see, Private Eyes can make some bank. Just fall around cheating husband. Take some pictures, set up some bugs. Some easy money.
Well, if I ever need one, you'll be my guy.
It's really sweet. I'll give you a good rate. Oh.
Well, all that sounds great, but I could use a hot shower and a nice scrubber.
I think they try to be less conspicuous.
They want us to see it.
Yeah, well, I'd like to take a pot shot and clip the damn thing.
Sam, now what have you done?
Oh, you know me. Can't keep a match out of my hands. can take pretty much anyone, but it's gonna be my chemistry degree that kills me. Okay, boss. You're gonna have to take this one. I can't deal with a headache and a burn. I'll be in my cave.
How's my favorite liberal state rep?
Fine, Charlie. Just dropping Penny off at school. Listen, Charlie, about the hearing. We need to talk damage control.
No damage on our end, Roger. Nothing unintended anyway.
Charlie, this is serious. We need to talk face to face. Listen to me. This is important.
Fine. We're going to have a small party for Betty. I have
Sam send you over the details. It'll give you a chance to see a nice drone some people from Washington sent over.
Drone? Why would they send a drone over your ranch? Just have Sam send me the details, please.
Dad, why do you waste your time with that fascist conspiracy nut?
Come on, Penny, you've been around the game long enough. You know a campaign costs money. I got this guy Harris by only 4 points. I just need... Well, politics aside, Charlie and I go way, way back. He looks at things one way, we look at things another way. I wouldn't go so far as to call him a fascist. Hey, Charlie's always been good to you.
Well, being good and being right are completely separate things. I mean, I've seen his ramblings on the internet. It's disgusting. All those accusations about the president. I mean, a man as rich as Gray and there's all these poor people in the area and he just hoards it to himself. Halfway decent man to spread his wealth around.
Well, he does. He's actually my largest donor.
We're doing a teaching at a women's clinic. That is if your patron, Mr. Gray, doesn't mind that I choose what to do with my body.
Ah, all right. Can you pause your lecture long enough to give your old sellout dad a kiss goodbye, please?
Love you, Dad.
Feels good to hold the real thing in your hands.
Just joking there.
Now, you know what I mean, real bullets, not that paintball crap.
Gentlemen, let's do this on three, huh? One, two.
I win. Y'all cheated and I still whooped you both.
Well, the sister shoots better than y'all.
Frankie? Yeah, she probably does.
Well, my guy's dancing with his 72 virgins.
That's an excessive amount of inexperienced women.
Dead either way.
Vehicles.
UN logo on the side.
Yeah, but what the hell is the UN doing here?
There's gotta be some good reason. We need to know, we'll know.
Of the best two out of three?
Huh?
President of the United States, welcome. There are two attaches each for you on the outskirts of the camp. If you would, please.
Hey, Mama. Hey, Mom. I tell you, there is something wrong with that girl out there. Seems like anything with a barrel or a blade is a toy to her.
Probably, because she's just like her brother.
Mama, you were supposed to start taking your medicine.
I'm done.
Done with what? This isn't even open.
All the pills, the shots, the scans, the probes, everything. I still got cancer. It's not going anywhere.
Mama, besides, I feel great. Just great.
From now on, I'm living on faith. It serves me real good.
I know, Mama, but you can't just give up.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Now, when did I ever give up? Not me. Oh, Frankie, thank you, darling. Listen, you've done enough for today. That's it. Okay?
Frankie, would you please back me up here and explain to your grandmother that she needs to start taking her medicine?
Girls, listen to me. And listen good. Look around. Look at the world. In my dreams, I see it. I see it just as plain as day. World's going to hell in a handbasket. Charlie sees it too. And when it comes, Frankie, you take your mother, you just get over to Charlie's. He will be able to protect you, and he will want to.
Who's going to protect Brandon?
God will protect Brandon.
Does anybody else have a job?
Now listen up. Domestic threats have now become the top priority of this administration. Subsequently, we will be starting a series of training exercises, military operations, and urban terrain. Lieutenant Lane, you have a question?
Yes, sir. Colonel, what domestic threats are we talking about?
There are a variety of scenarios, not the least of which mass attacks on the homeland, at which time it will become necessary to protect the majority of the citizens against the minority of the extremist.
And who defines the term extremist, sir?
That would be your commander-in-chief, Joint Chiefs of Staff. That fits with your approval, Lieutenant?
Perfectly, sir.
Very well. Local law enforcement will be undermanned and outgunned and unable to stop armed gangs or militia. Every man, woman, and child in America will be looking to each and every one of you and everyone under your command to restore order. Will you be ready?
Yes, sir.
I did not hear you.
Yes, sir.
Hoorah!
Hoorah!
Dismissed.
Malcolm, you have a lot on your mind.
A sustainable population of our planet is no more than 500 million.
And we're willing to kill 7 billion.
Well, most of those lives aren't worth living. The mass of humanity in Africa, India, and China, they live in squalor. They'd be better off dead. The world would be better off without them.
And America will be first.
Yes, well, as our friend Henry Kissinger said, a strong America is the only thing standing in the way of a new world order. We have foreign troops on the ground now, under the UN banner. The country only needs a little chaos.
The American people are resilient. What's to come? The citizens rise up.
Yes, well, when parents see their children starving and families hauled away to FEMA camps for imprisonment or worse, then yes, we expect some resistance at first. But the vanity of nationalism will quickly fade. The people will beg for help, any help. These are but the birth pangs. Change. Birth pangs of a new world order.
The sign says River Street. So, how do we tell Tango versus a friendly?
You heard the colonel. Consider all armed a target.
I don't know, Lieutenant. This is like training in America.
In America. I know. Let me remind you, the Boston bombers were U.S. citizens.
Not so sure about that.
States Army.
Hey there. How can I help you, gentlemen?
My name is Lieutenant Lane. Martial law has been declared. Under martial law, we need to know if you have any weapons in your home or on your possession.
Oh, no. Not a gun guy. Never really understood that whole right to carry thing. You and the police are the only ones that need it anyway. You can feel free to come in and check. My name's David.
All right. Thank you, David. Just a random check, sir. Do you know of anyone in the neighborhood who may have weapons?
Well, I don't want to get involved, but my next-door neighbor, he's a bit patriotic. He's got NRA stickers, and he's a bit of a gun nut. Quite frankly, I'm frightened of him.
Good. Thank you, sir. Sorry for the intrusion.
Oh, no problem. Just happy you're here to help us.
That wasn't weird at all.
It was like a step for life with the beauty.
Let's just knock this out. Stay on mission.
Perfect. Stay on mission. Who is this platoon leader?
Lieutenant Brandon Lane. Third in line of good military men. Mother's a veterinarian. Sister is 15 years old. Shoot the eyes out of a turkey at 100 yards. Father was KIA in Iraq. Anything else you need to know?
You can see he has the hearts of his men. If you have his, you have theirs. If not...
Yeah, I get it. He's a wild card. But he's tameable.
United States Army, please come to the door.
What can I help you with?
Please just come to the door, sir.
You own private property.
I understand that, sir. But under martial law, we need to know if you have any weapons inside your home or on your person.
Well, as a matter of fact, I do. All legal, all licensed. Just like the Second Amendment allows.
I understand that, sir.
But martial law has been declared, and under the National Defense Authorization Act,
I am going to send in my men to search for and confiscate any weapons that you have.
No, you're not.
Don't do that again, sir.
Get the hell off of my property.
I'm gonna ask you one more time. Do you have any weapons inside or on your person?
I already told you I do. And I'll use them too if you don't get the hell off of my property.
Martial law has been declared.
Don't give a spit about your martial law. Get the hell off my property.
Go, go, go.
I'm just doing.
Who told you could shoot one of my men?
I'm doing what they told me to do, man. I'm a crisis actor.
Ben.
I'm a crisis actor, man. This is not my calling. This is not, I need another job.
The meeting with Professor Stern go?
Well, he's decided to publish Feminist and Fabulous.
Oh my god! Yeah. Like your own manifesto!
I know, I mean, I couldn't make up the stuff he was saying to me. Your generation finally has the chance to bury the God and Guns culture, and I can't even remember what else.
So cool.
You know he's right. You're gonna change the world.
I'm gonna change the world.
Sir.
Stand at ease.
Yes, sir.
Do you want to explain to me what that stunt was you pulled in training?
Sorry, sir. Concern for my man. I lost control.
Losing control is not an option, Lieutenant. Shit happens in exercises just like it does in the real world. Now, you want to tell me just exactly what is biting you in the ass?
Sir?
I need to know you're on board with this program.
Understood, sir. The last 2 weeks of our training has slowly turned into more...
I explained that. It's about saving American lives.
Then why did I see a UN vehicle pull up and two non-Americans get out? You saluted them both. They didn't look like allies to me.
That is classified, Lieutenant. And if I hear you utter a single word about anything you may or may not have seen, I will see to it that the only training you do for the rest of your freaking life is push-ups in the brig. Am I clear, soldier?
Yes, sir.
There will be a briefing tomorrow, 0700. It will further clarify things. Do not be late.
Yes, sir.
Dismissed.
Hello?
Mr. Gray, it's Brandon Lane.
Brandon, how you doing, son? What's wrong?
Well, just strange things have been happening here.
Strange how?
Well, I've seen a UN vehicle come and go, and...
There's rumors of foreign soldiers on base.
Really?
Yeah.
Lately, our training's been more like urban warfare.
Have they mentioned domestic terrorism?
Yes, sir, they have.
Brandon, listen to me carefully. You may be having to make some very difficult decisions.
I'm sorry, Mr. Gray, I gotta go. That's right, sir.
She is my pride and joy. Goes with me everywhere. Did you know this little lady right here has been to Iraq twice?
Colonel, is there a Mrs. Green?
Is there a Mrs. Crane? Oh, there was a Mrs. Crane. But I got the motorcycle anyway. Times are changing, Lieutenant. Better change with them. You get left behind.
Can you see that, sir?
President, Operation Dark Star has commenced. You listened to me very, very carefully, Mr. President. You knew damn good and well when we vetted you that this day was going to come. Well, the committee and I have decided now is the time. This was a courtesy call, neither a warning nor a threat. When you sell your soul, it's a one-time thing. There's no going back. Goodbye, Mr. President.
All right, don't panic. Just keep the horse upright. I'm on my way. I got a horse in breach.
Frankie, Sam's gonna pick you up and take you over to Mr. Gray's house, okay?
Awesome. Maybe Sam will let me use one of her AR-15s.
Good Lord, Frankie.
Listen, I'm going to go ahead and go with Frankie to Charlie's because, look, I know about my surprise birthday cake. Don't worry about me seeing it. I think it's great, just great what you're doing. But Charlie and I have some talking to do.
I got a mother that wants to start a militia, and my daughter wants to fight one. This is why I became a veterinarian.
Uh-huh.
Lord help me.
I love you.
I love you, Mom.
We're gonna skadoot and skedaddle.
All right.
Be seated. By order of the Commander-in-Chief, we will be cooperating with the United Nations. We'll be running joint drills here stateside.
Colonel, if I may.
Floor is yours, Colonel.
Now,
My name is Colonel Cashwell. I'm here with Colonel Wong on behalf of the UN. Our countries have found it beneficial on a number of different levels to come together as friends under the United Nations banner to do joint exercises in the case of any type of either natural or civil unrest.
Can I get anything for the birthday girl?
No, thank you. This is doing me just fine. Charlie, could you sit down for just a moment, please? I'd like to talk to you. I recall very vividly a radio program in 1950. And this man was testifying in front of Congress, and he said, "We shall have world government, whether we like it or not. The only question is if world government will be accomplished by conquest or consent."
He made a bold and stupid statement. Unfortunately, it's true.
Well, look who I found lurking outside.
Lurking, what can you expect? The gentleman is a politician.
Oh, Mama.
Roger, I just wanted to bust your chops and keep you humble.
Always good to see you, ma'am.
Pleasure's mine.
Charlie?
How is it every campaign I give you money, but I never vote for you?
Well, I aim to change that.
So it's got you all dark and brooding, Lieutenant?
Got better eyes than you think, Ham. She dumped me when I joined.
Now you're sitting here wondering just what the hell it is you're doing. You sign up to defend a country that's getting hard to recognize. Something like that.
Yeah, something like that.
So I think you should know about this, sir.
What is it?
It's something I'm gonna put in my footlocker for when the fit hits the shan. If something happens to me, it's yours.
I ain't gonna let nothing happen to you.
I'm gonna put this back.
Release the device.
There's more how to play this stupid thing.
Lights are off.
I'm sure it's nothing. Don't worry about it.
You're gonna stay with me, right?
Of course. I'm not going anywhere, okay?
It happened, didn't it?
I'm not sure, but we'll find out soon.
So they must hit a transformer.
We just got hit by an EMP. We should go help him. There's nothing we can do, Tim. There's no trucks. Nothing works.
And what's that?
The truck's old school. Pre-electronics. It must have had some protected somewhere.
It's awfully convenient.
We deploy in 1 hour. Ready your platoons. We have support coming from Fort Campbell. Move out.
Hold up, Colonel. Sir, what's the mission?
You do not tell me to hold up.
Sir, what is the mission?
Martial law has been declared, Lieutenant.
Martial law? Already it just happened.
We're gonna have to restore order, so you tell your men to get their gear and mount up.
What is our mission?
Restore order, disarm the population, subdue resistance at any cost.
There is no way martial law was declared that quickly.
Lieutenant, you will follow my orders or I will have you arrested.
Sir, I have sworn to protect and defend the Constitution of the United States. I will not fire on innocent American citizens.
And you will die.
Back off, guys. Stand down, that's an order.
Now, Colonel, what to do with him?
Lock him up. We'll deal with him later.
I'm not going anywhere.
Bad call, son.
Let's go, guys. Come on.
He's dead, Lane. You don't know what's going on. You're dead!
Hey, boss.
It was an EMP.
Anyone coming down here won't be with good intentions. Though I'd say everyone's laying low. I'll be writing this out tonight.
Tonight, but give it a day or two. We've got what they want.
Well, Charlie, thank you again for letting us stay with you.
It's a good idea if you let Sam take you down to your house to get what you and your family need.
We could leave before sunup. We could.
Come on, guys, hurry up.
Come over here to your grandmother. You know, when I was your age, I was a tough son of a biscuit eater just like you. Go, your old grandmother's just fine.
Thanks, Grandma.
Oh.
Excuse me, ladies.
Hello? Anybody home? Hello?
What do you want?
Please, sir. I'm no trouble. Soldier trying to get home.
What's your name, boy?
Brandon Lane. Lieutenant. Well, I was.
Lieutenant, huh?
Yes, sir.
I reckon I got two options with you. Why don't I stick a bullet right here in your face?
Please, friend. Sir.
Or two, I figure out who you are and what's going on. Is that what you want?
Yes, sir.
Come on in.
Your president has signed all executive orders that gives the United Nations full control of your country and constitution. With no constitution.
I knew there was corruption in Washington, D.C. But these sons of bitches are making toilet paper out of our Constitution.
Yeah, for starters.
Well, your friend that had this.
Killed. By those men.
I'm sorry. But how did this thing survive an EMP attack?
It was in his metal locker, so. Just luck, I guess.
I don't believe in luck.
Your country is going to the dogs right now, Charlie. There have been rumors of FEMA camps being set up. The beast has reared its ugly head.
It's only North America.
That's what the news is here.
I appreciate any news you can send our way.
Copy that. Be safe, Charlie.
You need to get me out of here.
Obviously, your car's dead.
Yes, it is.
You don't get it, do you?
I am a state representative. We are in a crisis. I need to get back to Austin and help figure this out.
Figure what out?
What we need to do to fix the problem.
You were the problem. You can kiss your government goodbye.
What? You think a power outage has just erased our government?
Oh, there's a government, all right. Just not the one you're used to.
That's absurd.
Time to act was when this problem was preventable.
How? You tell me, Charlie. How is this preventable?
The congressional reports I sent you, all the recommendations of the panel. You didn't read a single one of them that I sent you, did you?
Oh, Charlie, do you know how much crap goes across my desk every day?
You've already blown this. And what you really need to be thinking about now? Penny.
Seems like the power should have been on by now.
Yeah, but no power means no class tomorrow.
Yeah, I'm getting kind of tired. I'm gonna go up soon. Me too. I don't even know what time it is.
Look, I bet you the sun's gonna be up in like an hour. So we just ride it out.
thought you could hide from me.
Nightmare.
Yes, sir.
Tough to shake. Took me years. Coffee? I know it ain't the best, but...
Not so bad.
You're a terrible liar, Lieutenant. It shows your character.
Charlie, if that really was an EMP yesterday.
Half a million people perished last night. And things are only going to get worse.
How could it get worse?
No power. Everything shuts down. Hospitals, fuel, travel, food spoils. The average American family only has 3 days of food. Hungry people do desperate things to feed their families.
And all of this could have been prevented.
Yes.
I wish I had more fuel for you.
It'll be fine. It'll get me going. Yeah, I appreciate the food, clothes, everything.
Hey. I don't know what you're gonna come across on your way home. I don't even know what the world looks like now. You're holding a powerful truth. What you decide to do with it, it's gonna be very dangerous. Godspeed.
Thanks, Harlan.
Frankie, do you understand what's happening?
No. All I know is the power went out.
You're a smart girl, Frankie. What do you want? Tooth Fairy version? Or the truth?
I want the truth.
Truth is, this is a time when folks run and hide. Or they pull up their bootstraps and they fight. Man, woman, young or old.
I'll fight.
Kelly?
Hey, Mom. I'm just so afraid of the world that you're going to have to grow up in. I just want my family back together again.
Kelly, baby, come here.
Roger, I need to show you something, but I can't show the politician who I don't trust to keep his big mouth shut.
Yes, if it means getting Penny back safely, absolutely. You have my word.
Faraday cage. Military's been using them since the 50s.
I'm sorry, a Faraday cage?
No, it's a building that protects electronics from an EMP. It'd be as simple as a jury-rigged trash can. Or, well, this. That chopper? That's what Sam and I gotta take to go get Penny.
Hey there, friend.
No power here either?
Nope. Nada.
We can use some fuel. Enough to fill the tank and the jug.
It might be a little tough. You don't need to keep it for the town. There's no telling when the power...
Yeah, I hear you. No problem.
But maybe if you sweeten the pot.
What are you thinking?
You got any guns?
Nah. Don't let the military bike fool you, man. I'm a pacifist.
It's gonna take a lot of money then.
Maybe I got something better. 1 ounce of silver. Right now it could be worth a grand.
Shit.
Come out now.
Please don't hurt me.
You Toby?
Yeah. This is my store. What is left of it.
I'm not gonna hurt you. This big fella have anything to do with this? Toby, can I please have some gas now?
Let's keep looking, we'll find her.
I say we stay low, avoid any stray pops coming at us.
Let's do this.
Let's do it.
There she is. Get her.
Thank you.
where's the politician's daughter?
There she is.
I got her.
Shut up, or I'm gonna bash your face in.
I've been looking everywhere for you.
You left me.
I'm sorry.
Penny, we gotta go!
Mr. Green was here.
Your science teacher?
He used to be a farmer before all this GMO Frankenstein food came along.
You know what? Overwhelming evidence indicates there's no scientific fact that GMOs pose any kind of threat, any kind of danger. I mean, you people, you all live in a bubble. I mean, what do you think the government's supposed to do?
Our government isn't supposed to feed anyone. Farmers are.
Hey, Frankie, I don't think this is the right time or place for this discussion.
Come in, Lima Romeo.
Go ahead, we read you.
We just crossed the property line with Penny and Kelly. There's a soldier making his way to the house.
Is it Brandon?
It sure looks like it.
Pretty tough for a politician's kid. Come on.
You must have gone through a lot to get here.
Yes, sir. Actually, I've got something that's been burning a hole in my pocket. It's belonged to a good friend of mine. A good soldier.
How'd the recording survive the EMP?
Been told not to call it luck, so. A miracle?
Colonel, you know with the UN Secretary and your president getting ready to declare martial law, your troops must be prepared to fire on American citizens, whether armed or not.
Yeah, I get it.
I don't understand. I mean, how...
Had you been willing, you would have known that this stuff is all around. It's not a left thing or a right thing. Every administration for the last 50 years has been working towards this. Rubber stamping executive orders.
How could they have kept it a secret for so long?
Nothing happens by accident. This is a smoking gun.
and I need to get back to the Capitol.
Well, if you're really set on it, you could probably do some good in Austin. It's time to advise the governor for Texas to secede.
Do you know what that would take?
I want you to come with me to the radio room. There's something I want you to hear that'll help you make your decision.
In New York and LA, FEMA camps have been set up. Chicago looks to be going down fast, with looters tearing up the city. Those that haven't been detained are going to be looking for a place of refuge.
Ian, stand by, please.
Play.
Your president has signed all executive orders that gives the United Nations full control of your country and constitution. With no constitution.
This is Lieutenant Brandon Lane, United States Army. The recording you just heard was given to me by Sergeant William Hamm. He was killed by the men that you just heard.
Yes, sir. There is only one thing to do, sir. I will find Lane. I will bring him here, and he will publicly confess to this hoax.
I'm gonna rip his throat out.
Alone again.
You're not alone. Your dad has the truth now. He may be our only chance.
Things are never going to be the same again, are they?
I don't think so.
I'm tired.
Hold on a sec. Please. Stay.
Please stay. That's what I said to Justin. To my mom. That's what I said to you.
Can I remind you? You're the one that ended things between us.
What was I supposed to do? Just wait around?
Yeah, while... you were.
Until when? Until you came back in a body bag? I couldn't face that. I'm sorry, I couldn't. I loved you.
I never stopped. I never will.
Sergeant Timms. Lieutenant Lane is here. Deserter, a domestic terrorist. Is he really worth all this suffering? Help me stop this. Tell me where he went.
How am I supposed to know?
You served with him for 3 years. You expect me to believe that?
Go to hell.
Again.
I think with just a few more people, we could button this place down.
I agree. We don't need to stress our resources. How many are you thinking?
I'd say 3 more would work. In Afghanistan, 1 small squad could be more effective than the entire company. So.
Sam?
I know a guy.
JD, he lives in town. He's pretty set up for now. But I'm not sure for how long. His wife and he both serve in the military, so they're good. She's a badass.
Yeah, I know JD and Sandra.
I volunteer. Sam already taught me how to
work.
Then what about Mr. Green?
You said he was a farmer.
Before that, he was a policeman.
That's a useful combination of skills. Sam, call on JD and his wife. Frankie, I'll find Mr. Green. We've got to harden our defenses while we can.
Yeah, it'd be nice to have a bunch of these, but it's a lot of digging.
Yeah, it is. We can handle that. Positioned accurately is going to be highly effective. I think I might have an idea on how we can get a little extra bang for our buck with the spider holes.
Still making killing machines out of dental floss and toothpicks?
Always. Oh, Frank.
JD, really nice to meet you.
Thank you. Nice to meet you.
We're really glad you're here.
Thanks for having us. We're here to help.
We're stronger together.
Okay, guys, there's two primary points. First of all is the compound where we're located right now.
Right.
The other one is the Faraday cage, which contains our ammunition and supplies.
Secure, right? We have fencing all the way around. 2 points of entry.
Perimeter secure, however, we've got to guard the fence line because it is vulnerable and cut or driven through.
Charlie. Why us? Why are you taking us in?
I care about you. And I care about your children.
The world's a different place.
Who knows what tomorrow's going to bring?
Miscalculation?
What?
A miscalculation. Ah, the air pressure wasn't quite right.
What the? Sam, what is that thing?
Oh, it's a Molotov cocktail launcher. Calling it the Molotovinator. I just got a couple tweaks. You want to come see?
Let's get this garden finished.
for? Did you say Uniform November?
Affirmative! Sector 1 approaching fast!
How many?
I don't know, maybe 3-4 vehicles. I'm hauling out to the gate.
United Nations. And I guarantee you this is not a social call. Get down to Section 1 now. Penny, take Betty to the radio room.
Where's Frankie?
Hey, guys.
Stall him. We're getting into position.
All right, what do you want me to stall him with, my vivacious personality? Frankie?
Gus, is Frankie with you? Can't find Frankie.
She's gonna be okay. JD's waiting for her at the bottom of the hill. I need you. Stay here, okay?
Okay.
Keep an eye on Penny.
Sure, okay.
You know where the guns are.
You bet. We won't teach these bastards they can't mess with our country.
My name is Colonel Cashel, commander of United Nations Special Brigade. I'm here to arrest Lieutenant Brandon Lane on charges of murder and desertion. You are to hand him over to me immediately.
I'm sorry, what did you say your name was?
Cashel.
Gesundheit.
This is not a joke.
Well, that's just your name. Bad joke.
I assure you, I'm not joking.
Yeah, okay, I got it. You're serious. All right. But I'm curious. Who or what gave you the right to come down here and make these ridiculous demands?
The laws of your land by your president in declaration of martial law.
Okay, well, I'm not an attorney, Mr. Russia. But it'll be a hot day in Siberia before we turn Brandon Lane over to you.
Apparently, you are not caught up on the laws your president has signed. The National Defense Authorization Act, Executive Order 13603, approved by your Congress.
That's a mouthful of nonsense. Quite frankly, I just kick ass and take names, and I'm a part-time inventor. I kind of suck at it, but...
I am authorized to confiscate any items which may present a danger to the citizens of the United Nations. If you hand Lane over quietly, I will confiscate these items peacefully.
And if not, then what? Burn the place to the ground? Which executive order is that?
Be ready. Shoot first if they move.
I should have killed you when I had the chance.
You did have the chance, but you didn't take it. You failed.
Not this time.
Is that the American?
Affirmative. He makes one wrong move, I'm gonna kill him.
You had what it takes, Lane. You could have been a good soldier. Instead, you turned into a coward.
I am a good soldier.
You're the coward and a traitor.
Bring him to me!
Timms!
Sorry.
You know that I will not hesitate to paint this fence with body parts. He cried like a baby. He sang like a bird, and he brought me right to you. You now have 5 seconds.
Let him go.
5, 4, 3.
Don't, Lieutenant!
2.
Of these Texans. Crash the gate!
They're mobilizing. Hold your ground.
I'm okay.
.50 cal's down. Now let's show them how we do it in Texas. Kick some ass. You gotta be kidding me.
Cover me, guys.
Frankie, I'm gonna check the indoor garden.
Kelly, no, please.
I'm going to find my daughter.
Hey, y'all got me? I'm in Spider 04. It's me they want. Mom, come get me.
Stay low, Frankie.
Goodbye, little girl. You're dead.
Get the chopper.
Stay out of missile lock.
Good shot, son.
Looks like we won the battle. But the war has just begun.
Our story may never be recorded in the annals of history. And our history is now nothing but fond memories of a once great nation. A nation founded by a legion of patriots with a scroll of simple principles. A nation bought and paid for by heroes that were willing to die for her. We are not willing to die for a puppet government run by a demonic elite. Jefferson was right. The tree of liberty must be refreshed from time to time by the blood of tyrants and patriots. It may not have been our choice, but we are the new patriots.